Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to look at another method of DFA minimization using a method known as the table filling method or the Myhill-Narod method. So in the previous technique that we used for DFA minimization, we tried to find out equivalent pairs and then we combine these pairs. So here also we are going to do the same thing, but the technique is slightly different. So let us see how this method works. So here I have a DFA with five states Q0 to Q4, and the input symbol is your 0 and 1. So this is the, and this is your transition table that we have. Now for this we would like to minimize the DFA so that we can combine some of the steps or some of the states into single states. So to do that, first let us see how this technique works. Okay. So what we are going to start with is we are going to take pairs. We are going to create a table like this. So for every row, for every state, we are going to have one row each and one column each. So here I have five states, so I have five rows and five columns. So my table consists of five rows and five columns. Out of these, I'm going to remove some of these cells because these are repetitions, or it is this is a symmetric, since it's a table, it is symmetric. So I'm going to remove some of the cells, like say for example 00. So since it's a single state, I'm going to just remove this 01. Okay. Similarly, 11, 22, 33, and 44. Now, if you look at the remaining, like here you see 1 and 0. This is the same as 0 and 1. That means this cell, the cell here. So this cell, the cell here, these two cells are same. So what we are going to do is we are going to keep only one because they are the same. So let me just remove this, and I'm going to remove this cell. I'm going to keep only one. So same for the rest also. I'm going to just the upper triangle of this table, I'm going to remove it. So I will be concerned only with the remaining cells. Now what we are going to do is we are going to take the cells as pairs, like 0 and 1. So this cell corresponds to the pair Q0 and Q1. So if the two states are equivalent, then we are going to consider this cell. So how do we test if it is equivalent? So let us look at our table. So here I have this first, I will take the set Q0 and Q1. Q0 and Q1. So if you look at Q0 and Q1, if you look at the table, you will find that on 0, Q0 goes to Q1 and Q1 goes to Q2. Now both Q1 and Q2 are non-final states. Final state is only Q4. So for 0, these two are okay. Let us look at for input 1. So for input 1, Q0 goes to Q3 and Q1 goes to Q4. Now Q3 is a non-final state, whereas Q4 is a final state. So Q0 and Q3 and Q4, they are not this, they do not belong to the same set. So Q0 and Q1, we are going to mark it. We are going to mark this cell because why? They are not equivalent. So Q0 and Q1 are not equivalent. So we are going to mark the corresponding cell in our table. So if we go to the table, so Q0 and Q1, this table, we are going to mark it like this. Okay, so remember this is a different mark from the green ones, because the green mark shows the cells which are unused, whereas this mark shows the cells or the set of states which are not equivalent. So let us go back. Now let me take the second pair, Q0. So Q0 I took with Q1, now Q0 with Q2. Let us see. Again, same way. Q0 with Q2. So Q0 on 0 goes to Q1. Q2 on 0 goes to Q1. Okay. But on 1, Q0 goes to Q3 and Q2 goes to Q4. So while for 0 input, both the states are Q1, Q1. Whereas for input 1, 1 is a non-final state, whereas the other is a final state. So these two are also not equivalent. So Q0, Q2 is also not equivalent. So we are going to mark Q0, Q2. Then we will take the next pair, which is Q0, Q3. Q0, Q3. So same, if we look at this, Q0, Q3, we have Q0 on 0 is Q1, Q3 on 0 is Q2. Both are non-final states, so no problem. For 1, it is Q3, and for Q3, it is Q4. So again, non-final and final. So Q0, Q3 are not equivalent. So since they are not equivalent, we are going to mark this. And obviously, 0 and 4, these are your non-equivalent. Why? Because 0 and 4, 0 is a non-final state, 4 is a final state. So we can mark this. In fact, we can mark all states, all cells where one is a final state and the other is a non-final state. So 4 is a final state, 0 is a non-final state. So we can mark it. Then 1 is a non-final state, 4 is a final state. So we can mark it. Similarly, 2 and 4, 1 is final, 1 is non-final, we can mark. And 3 and 4 also, 1 is final, 1 is non-final, so we shall mark. Now we are left with 1, 2, cell 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3. So let us see if these are equivalent. So I will just remove these so that we can write the new set of cells. Okay, so now let us take the cells Q1, Q2. So Q1 and Q2. So Q1, if you see, Q1 on 0 goes to Q2, Q2 on 0 goes to Q1. Both are non-final states. Look at 1. So 1 on Q1 on input 1 goes to 4. Q2 on input 1 goes to 4. So now both are final states. Q4, Q4 is the same state. So now we can say that Q1 and Q2 are equivalent. So Q1 and Q2, we will say that these are equivalent. So if we find that it is equivalent, then we are not going to mark that cell. So we are not going to mark the cell. Let me just, so this cell, we will leave it unmarked. Okay, and we will go to the next set. So next set is 1, 3. So let's go to 1, 3. So in 1, 3, Q1, Q3. Okay, again let us see. Q1, Q3. Q1 on 0 is Q2. Q3 on 0 is Q2. So we are not, both are non-final state. For 1, Q1 on 1 is Q4. Q3 on 1 is also Q4. So these are both non-final states and these are both final states. So Q1, Q3 is our equivalent. So we are going to leave that cell Q1, Q3 also as unmarked. So we will leave this as unmarked. I'm just marking it in blue. I'm just putting a highlight in blue so that we can distinguish with the rest. Then we are left with the last pair, that is 2 and 3. 2 and 3. So Q2 and Q3. Q2, Q3. So Q2, Q3, if we see, Q2 on 0 is Q1, Q3 on 0 is Q2. Again, both are non-final states. Q2 on 1 is Q4, Q3 on 1 is also Q4. Again, both are final states. So now here also, Q2 and Q3 are equivalent. So Q2 and Q3 are equivalent, so we are not going to mark this. So these three cells we got, which were left unmarked. Now we don't have any more cells left. Others all are marked. Okay. So now we will see which are the cells that we are left with. So we are left with unmarked cells 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3. So let us write them down here. Q1, Q3, Q1, Q2 and Q2, Q3. So what these three cells mean? It means that these states are equivalent. So as you can see here, I have Q1, Q3, Q1, Q2 and Q2, Q3. Now from the transitive property, I have Q1 is equivalent to Q2, Q2 is equivalent to Q3, so therefore, and Q1 is equivalent to Q3. So we can say that Q1, Q2 and Q3, all three states are equivalent. So we can combine all three states, Q1, Q2 and Q3. So we can get the transition table like this. So now I am left with states Q0, then the new state Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. And Q4 remains our final state and Q0 remains our starting state. So on input 0 and 1, Q0 on 0, as we can see from our state, Q0 on 0 goes to 1. So now it will go to 1, 2, 3. And Q0 on 1 again goes to 3, so 3 is a part of the cells of the state Q1, Q2, Q3. So on 0 and 1, it will go to the same state. So it will go to Q1, Q2, Q3. And Q0 on 1 also goes to Q1, Q2, Q3. And Q1, Q2, Q3, if you see, on 0, Q1 goes to Q2. On 0, Q3 goes to Q2. And on Q2, on 0 goes to Q1. So it goes to itself. So we can write Q1, Q2, Q3 goes to itself on 0. And on input 1, we can see that all of these, they go to Q1 on 1 goes to Q4. Q2 on 1 goes to Q4. And Q3 on 1 goes to Q4. So we can write here, this goes to Q4. And Q4 on 0 and 1, it goes to itself. So we have Q4 out here. So this is our new transition table of the minimized DFA. And if we have to draw it, it is going to look something like this. So Q0, starting state. Q1, Q2, Q3. This is the new combined state. And Q4, which is our final state. So Q0. On 0 goes to Q1, Q2, Q3. And on 1 also it goes to Q1, Q2, Q3. Then Q1, Q2, Q3 on 0 goes to itself. And on 1 it goes to Q4. And Q4 on both 0 and 1 it stays in Q4 itself. So this is our mini. Filling.